All right, everybody, welcome back to the TPSmethod.com Get Strong video log. We put the mustache signal up, but Russ has not responded to it, so we don't know where he is. No. We're hoping he doesn't punch someone at Dunkin' Donuts today. You never know what's going to happen, right? Anyway, so once a week, we answer, sometimes twice a week, we answer one question from our members on the TPSmethod.com member forums. And this week, the question is from Gina. You can look down and you'll see the video of Gina doing Goodmornings. No, it's science. It's like down internet. There. You're going to put that in later. It's not there it's now.
Like, are you sure it's not just going to be all right here?
Oh, shit. You're going to do that to me?
Probably
so not. If you look somewhere on your screen at some point, it could be right now. It could be in a minute. I don't know.
It'd be in the face where Russ would be.
Yeah.
Tech guy is going to put a video of Gina doing Goodmornings that she posted in the forum for us. And she wanted a form check. So I'm going to pass this one off to Coach Ginger.
Hi. First, Gina, it is so nice to see you lifting. It's been a minute for me. You're a mother and an athlete, and I respect you. Like,
yeah, Gina's a badass.
Utmost respect. Yeah, absolutely.
Gina's a badass.
Total badass. So, nice to see a video, and you're part of the website. It's awesome. As you know, in our sport, there is repetitive loading.
This is a sport?
Yeah, or whatever.
Whatever you want to call it.
Jerk. All right. In the sport, there's repetitive loading in the movements we perform. There is also strong evidence that overuse and repetition in extension and flexion could possibly lead to disc and vertebrae injuries. So I'm going to address your neck position, and then Matt will address the lower body. Because we are looking for longevity by all means possible, using and maintaining a retracted head position instead of starting in the retracted head position and then on the way down and then throwing that head back into extension on the way up.
Chickens in the water.
Yes.
She's not a giraffe?
Not a giraffe. She's the whatever, I guess, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. A lot of people do it. Okay. So using that retracted head position can...
Some people are coached to do that.
I know. She's
fucking amazing.
We're
anyway.
Too smart to be stupid here. So we're going to use a retracted head position for the longevity of our body and for less risk of injury. So on the way up, just maintain that retracted head position. Doing that will also create more activity in the erectors and the obliques. And this is ultimately what we are looking for, longevity in the sport and good health.
And no injuries. So to just so people watching know what we're talking about, Gina was doing this in the video with her neck really, really hard.
On the way up.
And we don't want to do that. We want to just be neutral and just kind of drive the head back a little bit, tuck the chin a little bit. It doesn't have to be like this.
We don't want any flexion.
Yeah, we don't want anything out of the ordinary, just to... A neutral neck
position.
And a slight extension in the neck is okay. But we don't want it to be cranked back and jacked
especially
up.
Especially just no movement during the lift. Just maintaining start to finish.
Unless it's a third attempt deadlift and it stalls at the knees and then you throw your head back to get the lift.
I mean, yeah.
We've
that's
all
what
done
I
it.
Do.
Maybe not.
Maybe that's the point that
I might not do it anymore, though.
That's the point where I pass out and fall off the platform.
But for the rest of the good morning, you know. Murph said in the forum already, you know, you got to improve the rooting and bracing a little bit of what she's doing. But just in general, if you guys notice in the video, when she gets to the bottom of a good morning, her knees are actually behind her ankles.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So you don't want to do that when you do a good morning.
Why not?
And, well, here's what I'm going to just give you a visualization here. Let's make some comparisons. There's two types.
Are you going to put a graph up on the
screen? Two broad categories. We don't need a graph for
all
this.
Right.
Two broad categories of assistance exercises. And I think about them as like specific and non-specific assistance exercises. So you look at like specific would be a movement, like you're in a position with your body that you might find yourself in that position during a squat or during a deadlift. So if you think about a good morning,
pretty reasonable.
Your shin is straight. Here's your little stick figure, man.
This is where a graph would be good.
Yeah, maybe a graph or maybe like little stick figures. You might find yourself in that position during a conventional deadlift or during a squat, hopefully not too much during a squat, but never during a squat or a deadlift would you ever find yourself in a position where your knees are behind your ankles and then your hips are behind your knees and then you're leaned over past that. It's just unrealistic. The only way you could get away with doing that is by leveraging your body weight and doing this weird balancing act, which is kind of what you're doing in that good morning, where the weight is the only thing that's preventing you from falling over.
Right, so the rooting is going to be real big on that, so there's no leakage of that power through your feet.
So it makes it not specific, and looser and just not as effective of an exercise to training it for, you know, specificity of a deadlift or a squat or just to build up that strength back there.
So we want to be tighter and move better.
Right. Think about the movements that you're doing and right how they're going to translate to your actual main movements.
Yeah, so I don't remember what I wrote in the forum, but I'm sure that I wrote something about rooting and or bracing, if not both. And because if you look at the answer for rooting and bracing, if she rooted more firmly and braced harder, she would therefore be tighter.
Mm-hmm. There wouldn't be a balancing act.
And that cleans things up. But the one thing I do recall about the video that Matt may or may not have put on the screen somewhere, he probably did, right?
I think he probably did, right.
There was a lot of aggression in the set, which I like.
Absolutely.
I like that. She was attacking the set, but we need to partner our aggression with patience, okay? Yes. So certain exercises we could just get after. If you're doing a set of barbell curls, just fucking get after it. It's not a big deal, right? But a good morning with a couple hundred pounds on your back or more, we want to have some patience. You're going to stand upright, make sure everything's set, go back, reasonable pace, a little bit of a pause at the bottom. And then if you want to stand up violently fast, stand up violently fast. But then you're going to pause just a little bit at the top and reset everything. You're not going to go up and down like a basketball being dribbled. And that's what I recall. It was a very quick pace on the good mornings. So I would have liked to see her slow down a little bit. And by slowing down a little bit, that would have done a lot of what Matt said.
Yes.
Partnered that with what Candace said. And I think we'll see the next time you do good mornings, they'll be great and you won't be hurt. So that's all I got. That's all we got? Or we got more?
Yeah, that's good.
I think that was a pretty good one. Thanks to the Bruisers for letting us use their music. And you can listen to them on the way out. And if you're not a member of TPSmethod.com, you can, please join. But you don't even have to join. You can try it for free. It's fucking free. Like, just, there's a box coming up in a second. It's free. You don't have to do anything. Sign up, right? You don't like it, you don't have to pay any money. If you like it, you stay. Powerlifting programs, Trainer for Life fitness programs, full video exercise library. Who knows, you may be an internet star. We may print out one of your questions from the forum on one of these neat pieces of paper and answer it here. Give it a shot. It's free. And it's very cheap after that, too. It's pennies a day. Try it out. I'm sure that you'll get stronger and you'll be more awesome. I believe that they did a study and it said that your personal awesomeness increases by 32.4%. When you sign up, was it 33.3.
Yeah.
All right. And now we're sending up the mustache signal. Where's Russ? I don't know. All right. Thanks for watching. That box is coming up right down here in a second. It's going to be here. It's not this one, but click this one, and it's not this one. It's this one.